We've been shipping GaN since before the beginning of since 2018, we've been shipping GaN devices. Our reliability information from our device testing shows that we have a fit, failures in time, of less than one. That means that you basically have an MTBF of over 1 billion hours, and that's pretty good. It's good enough for automotive applications, for example. We've shipped many tens of millions of GaN devices. So we're very confident in the reliability of GaN today. So GaN devices actually are fundamentally more rugged than silicon. We can show that the process is very reliable. So what's happening now is actually GaN was a new technology 3 years ago. Now GaN is expanding into being a ubiquitous technology. You can use it anywhere. We've got about 65 different application spaces that use GaN today across all our, and we do appliance products, industrial products, IoT, rapid charging, obviously, but different areas. So it's being used almost everywhere. There isn't an application space that GaN is not useful for. There's two things about driving a GaN transistor. We avoid all of those by integrating, because we recognize that driving a GaN transistor is not trivial. They switch on extremely fast if you let them, and that can cause destructive oscillations in the circuit, so you really have to be careful with your gate driving. There's another slightly more insidious problem with discrete GaN devices. So there are GaN technology likes to be on. It's a normally on switch in its fundamental form. And that's okay, but power supply engineers know that normally on devices are a problem to work with. So everybody wants to turn it into a normally off device. And the easiest way to do that is to embed some material below the gate structure, and that will create a normally off transistor. The problem with that is that you now make the gate very sensitive to voltage, in that to turn the gate on, and to fully enhance the channel, you might require about 5 volts. But the breakdown voltage for the gate is around 6 volts. So now you have to be very accurate with your gate drive to avoid damaging the device. The other solution to this is to rather let the GaN device remain as a normally on switch and replace the application with a GaN and a silicon switch in series in a Cascode. Now, the advantage of this, it allows the GaN to operate as a normally on device, but the switch combination acts as a normally off switch. And you drive basically into the silicon device, so you can have as wide an input voltage range for the gate as a silicon transistor can have. You can fully enhance the channel very easily, and you don't risk overstressing the gate. So we use a Cascode in all our devices because it makes it fundamentally easier to leverage the benefit of the GaN switch technology. By embedding it in the circuit, we take away things like the involvement of parasitics in the switching oscillation of the device. You have to be very careful, as I mentioned previously, about driving a GaN device when it tries to get turn on very quickly. So you have to increase the gate impedance. The gate resistance needs to be carefully controlled, as does the drive current into the transistor in a discrete application. We can size the gate driver because we're controlling all the parasitics inside the device. And that's fundamentally why it's much easier to provide a logic level input device. Effectively that's what we're doing, by using a IC to control the GaN device itself. We're kind of ambivalent about switch technology after all of these comments. We use GaN devices, we use silicon devices, and we use silicon carbide. So we just provide the benefit that you need in your applications. If you are very confident and experienced with designing switching circuits, you can use GaN without really a problem. You'll understand where the issues associated with parasitic drain source capacitance and where drain in parasitic inductances from traces is concerned. You will get very good performance. If you're a little bit less familiar, look at one of the integrated packages, something like a device where the drive stage is integrated with the switch. That will make it much easier for you to go from trying it to getting the benefits from it. We do provide a lot of design technology in the films of PI Expert design software. We provide very detailed reference designs to help the engineer do that. So, and our colleagues in the market from our competing companies do the same thing. So there's a lot of information out there about driving your GaN properly. So make use of those application notes, design guides, and design software from whichever source you're using your GaN from. The only caveat is that the application you put it into must value the increased efficiency. If you have no need for increased efficiency and everything's working fine, you don't use GaN yet, because GaN is still slightly higher cost than silicon. When the cost of GaN comes down, and it will come down to be very close to silicon, because fundamentally there is no difference in the cost of the process, you'll see that GaN is used everywhere it can be. The only area GaN will not probably be used is at very low power conversion, between 5 to 10 watts. And the reason is the GaN transistor for lower power can be a very, very small die indeed. In fact, it's very hard to make the die so small that you can actually put it into an IC package reliably. So at very low power, more area of the device is taken up for things like die interconnects. So at that point, GaN really doesn't bring you anything. So at that point, you'll see silicon used for a long time. We don't talk about GaN technology as the benefit. We talk about higher efficiency as the benefit, because that's the only reason to use GaN. If you can't use the benefits, don't use the switch. GaN devices will be used in more and more applications. As the cost comes down, silicon will start to become less and less common. There are still a lot of applications where silicon will be used, so it's not going away. But the best way of looking at it is where GaN can be used, GaN will be used. And it's going to start to migrate up into the area traditionally occupied by silicon carbide. So GaN is only going to expand. It's not going to be a niche product for the future. It's going to be everywhere.